All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland, Oregon. We're trying to break it all down. I just got back into town, and we are excited to be back in town, man. Back in Portland. You know, it was not that much warmer in San Diego over this week. I mean, Portland and San Diego, when San Diego gets cold, it basically is the same temperature as Portland is. And, boy, the locals were complaining about that temperature, for sure. But I got a lot to chat about, so I'm just going to break down a little video here. It is the Friday the 30th. Tomorrow I'm going to be at Matt Knight and to see the basketball team play the Beavs. If you guys are interested in going to that, check me out. I'll be there. Keep an eye out or whatever. But also, if you want to be a part of the live, I'd love to be able to do another live thing, recap the Holiday Bowl, everybody's thoughts on that. And that's probably going to look more like Sunday, if you guys are into that. We'll talk about that in a little bit. But a little recap here. So let's go ahead and get into it. A couple things happened today. First and foremost, UCLA played the Sun Bowl. They lost in tragic fashion. Basically did exactly what the Ducks did, except for they just gave up a field goal at the end, except for Oregon never did. But came right back at the end. You know, basically probably should have put this game away early on. They didn't. And they got kind of caught by it. DTR going down, that sucks. You never like to see that happen. UW last night. I did a live during that. That was pretty fun, you know, the UW game. I expected UW to win, and they did, and I was happy for them. So, you know, the back the pack thing, I get it. I understand the people who are like, dude, no, man, the rivalries, whatever. I love that. I'm a very independent thinker, so it doesn't bother me if you think a different way than I think. And I actually really leaned into that. When I was a young Sports Chat 503, the young Sports Chat, when I was a kid, though, I hated the Huskies. Absolutely hated the Huskies, hated the Beavs, and loved nothing else but to see their demise. As I've gotten older, I've kind of understood it a little bit different level. It feels like for me, I've grown up a little bit. I've matured a little bit and I see it from a little bit different angle, but, it's still in my mind, everything goes back to the Ducks. Like I said last night, everything, in my opinion, everything rotates around the Ducks. So, Matt Powledge goes to, Baylor, defensive coordinator. Now that's a big move up. That's pretty good for him. So it's awesome to see, Dan Lanning's tree continue to grow. Right, you've got Kenny Dillingham as a head coach, and then now you have Matt Powledge as a defensive coordinator in the first year, so that's looking pretty good. You would assume there's other guys going to be leaving at some point in time, whether it's this year or next year, if other guys get an opportunity. But you're also going to see guys want to be a part of this staff too, which is kind of a cool situation. So, you know, in one door, out the other door, that's how it goes in college football. Mace, Popo, both coming back. There's probably other guys coming back on that D-line as well. The D-line looks stacked for next year. And, you know, Mace did such a really good job in the Holiday Bowl, putting on pressure early and often. One of the things that we just lacked this year, it felt like, as Ducks defensively, was the pressure on the quarterback. And so seeing a guy like Mace really kind of lean into his role a little bit, other guys were kind of, you know, it was just kind of strapped. You know, Keith Brown played a great game. You know, if you just recap the game, I knew it would be Jeff Bossa all over the place. You know, there were some really cool plays I thought that they did where Jeff Bossa, like, was on the edge and leaving the middle completely open, switched back to the middle, did a lot of stuff with just using his speed and his athleticism that maybe you couldn't use with some of the other guys that they had in there before. And so I'd love to see some of these young athletic players get in there and get a chance to rep. You know, I thought you'd see a lot more guys get playing time, but the amount we saw I thought was pretty good. And I thought there was a really good opportunity for some of the defensive players to say, hey, this is my position still. I don't care who's coming in next, but this is still my position. And then I love the Holiday Bowl. You know, winning the Holiday Bowl, these guys are smoking cigars afterward, you know, and tell me that the bowls don't matter, right? I love this conversation. We have it all the time, you know, do the bowls matter? Well, the bowls definitely matter to Vegas. People are betting on them. They matter to the advertisers that fill this dead space between the holidays, and also just kind of as a festival time of year, people use it as a vacation and use it as that time to go with their families. I went this year solo, couldn't go with my son, but a lot of people make this kind of an annual thing. I talked with a couple people, it's actually interesting. I talked with a couple Duck fans that said the only game they go to is the bowl game. That's it. They love the Ducks. They watch the. They live in California. They don't go to Autzen. They used to, but now only game they go to is the bowl game. And that was pretty fun. That's a pretty good idea. So, I just love the bowl games, and I think it also leads into a lot of discussion going into next year, right? So Texas Tech blows out Ole Miss. Ole Miss was like everybody's sweetheart. Everybody thought Ole Miss was so good this year, and granted, these teams change and they evolve throughout the year, but you know, Texas Tech winning in that kind of fashion and having Oregon go play at Lubbock next year, that sets the table up even more. That's what you want. Again, all I look at it is through the lens of the Duck fan. Whatever was better for the Ducks, that's what I want. So do I want Texas Tech? Do I want Tyler Shuck? Do I want all that sort of stuff next year to be good? Yes. Yes. You know, do I care about Ole Miss that much? No. You know? Texas beating Washington. I mean, Washington beating Texas. I love that. I'm not anti-Texas by any stretch. I give Texas a lot of respect. But, you know, I made a comment, you know, about, you know, Texas being overrated. And of course, people think like, oh, yeah, the Ducks are overrated just as much. Texas has so much more history than Oregon. You can't compare the two. Texas is the number one or one of the number one athletic budgets in the country. They're an absolute giant. Oregon is nowhere near them, okay, on that level. Nowhere near. Now, are they better at football than Texas? Yes, and they have been, and they've beaten Texas. And they beat Texas when Texas was worse than they are this year. But, you know, Texas this year, they did a really good job. They won big games this year. Look at that Red Rivalry, Red River Shootout, you know, thing, right? The Red River Rivalry, whatever the hell they call it. It's a tongue twister, whatever the hell it is. Man, anyway, I love the fact that Washington went down to Texas, beat Texas in Texas. These are the kind of things that we need as a conference to knock off. And I understand why people don't want to root for Washington because they're a Duck fan. I get it. Or they don't want to root for the Beavs. I get it. But having the Beavs beat the living tar out of an SEC school, we don't get many shots at the SEC. So you got to swing big when you get a shot at it, right? And Beavs hit a gigantic home run. And on a 3-0 fastball, and then you have, you know, this Oregon game. I think everybody just expected Oregon to win. I don't think it was that impressive to the actual people, but it doesn't matter to us. We were there. We were the ones having fun with the thing. But you know, having Washington beat Texas when Texas is one of the better teams in the Big 12, I think Utah's going to beat Penn State. That's going to do something for our, you know, conference. USC, who cares? They're out anyway. But hopefully they beat Tulane. But I'm at the point where if they lose to Tulane, I'm kind of almost like going to laugh at that one because I don't really care about USC anymore. What I used to care about them when they were on our team in our conference, I don't care about them anymore. And I never really liked USC that much as like a, you know, like rooting interest. Like I wasn't like actively like happy with the Reggie Bush era or whatever, like I'm that stoked on it or whatever. I'm excited to see next year. That game at Autzen is going to be the absolute game of the year. So buy your tickets when you can, get them for that USC game. And probably you should just buy some extra tickets for that USC game and just hold on to them. Stock values are probably going to go up. That's probably going to be a hefty ticket in the future. So why not? That's what I love about bowl games. So okay, let's talk about Holiday Bowl just for a second. Holiday Bowl, I went back and watched the tape. I always like to kind of give a little bit of a recap without watching the tape because you're in the stadium, you see it completely different than when you do when you watch the broadcast. And, you know, what I was really impressed with was, one, I think Drake May is going to be a really good NFL quarterback. He can really throw the ball. And his timing, his understanding of the pocket. But I did think that Oregon put a lot of pressure on him, and I thought that was great. I thought that if you let him sit back there in a clean pocket, he'll pick you apart. And that was my fear. So Oregon defense did the first job of the entire game, offensively, defensively, was put some pressure on Drake May and push him off his spot and make him at least out-athlete you and get the job done, which you knew he was going to do at some point, right? He was going to do 50% of the time maybe already. Well, don't give it to him 100%, right? So I thought they did a good job there. Offensively, I thought they did a really good job just running the ball. And offensive line just was absolutely putting pressure on that defensive line. I don't think the defensive line for UNC had much going on. I think they did earlier in the year, and I think some of their pass rush guys were out. I think some of their other guys they had issues with, but it seemed like Oregon's offensive line could pretty much do what they wanted in this one. There were some costly penalties. The touchdown to Chris Hudson gets called back on a penalty against Marcus Harper. He's not even blocking anybody. He's just downfield a little bit, which, again, I get it. It's the rule, but it's a burn when it happens. Other than that, I think, Bucky just did a great job. Noah did a great job. Jordan James really did a great job. I was really impressed with Jordan James this year. Spot time. He didn't get that much of an opportunity this year to play. I was impressed, didn't give up the ball. That was the biggest thing for me. It was, I always feared the freshmen are going to fumble. And didn't give up the ball, which is good. And put himself in a unique opportunity to be the heavy back at a young age. I didn't like the couple plays in the Beav game, where it looked like maybe it was misread a little bit, where it was the first, second, third, and goal. You needed it right there. But those are things you can learn from. So if you don't get it now, let's get it in the future, right? So I'm stoked. I'm stoked on where everything's going. I think it's a fantastic time to be alive as a Duck fan right now. The big thing for me about the Ducks is you just got to keep the hope alive. You got to keep momentum going. And that's why I like the Bulls, because it keeps positive momentum going. And you get to the end of the season and you can celebrate a win like this and you can hoist a trophy and you can get on a stage and you can smoke cigars in the locker room and you can party and you can have this whole time. You have your family there. And it's like, that's what makes you want to go back. That's what makes you want to do it over again. It's the same kind of thing with golf. You have a couple really good shots in the round and you keep thinking about those good shots. You don't think about the bad shots here or there. You don't think about maybe a couple putts you missed. You think about that one putt you really drilled and you were so happy about it, right? So, it is what it is. I think the bowl game, I get it. Everybody wants the playoff. And then once we have the 12-team playoff, I do think the Bulls are probably going to be decimated at some point, and so, because nobody's going to really care that much about the Mayo Bowl or whatever it is. But I still feel like you're losing something there, because I think there's a lot of top 40 teams, let's say, because again, that's so many bowls, right? So think about all those teams that are not represented in the top 12. And it's not just the top 12 teams, it's the automatic qualifiers and it's everybody else. So it's like, the 12-team playoff is really going to take away from the Bulls. I hope there is still something left for those teams that aren't in that 12-team playoff that are still looking at a 9-10 win season and have an opportunity to cash it out on a positive note, and you get a chance like a Holiday Bowl, Tax Slayer Bowl, whatever the hell kind of bowl, Duke Mayo Bowl, whatever the thing you want to do. But I think it's all pretty positive for those schools that can win. Now, the schools that lose that bowl, it's just an exhibition. You just chalk it up to, it's an exhibition. Let's get back to work. It just adds more fuel to the fire. I think bowls are a win-win. So I think it gives the fan base, more importantly, and the boosters, more importantly, a chance to get everybody in and get everybody on board. So, all right, guys. Well, hey, thank you guys so much for watching Sports Chat 503. Today is Friday. I'll put this video out tomorrow, Saturday. I'll be in Eugene. If you guys want to go to that basketball game, cheap tickets, man. Go to that Beav game if you're in the area. If you're outside of the area, drive in, man. Have a little, Saturday night, New Year's Eve. Come on. And I'll be back in Portland by the time the shenanigans start really popping off anyway. So go celebrate some of that stuff. Tomorrow's also the big games of the CFP, which everybody's all fired up about. And I think it's going to be great, but I still think it's going to be Georgia and Michigan. And if it isn't, then that's awesome. That's college football. That's the storybook endings we're looking for. But yeah, let's go ahead and think about doing a live stream on Sunday, though. I think that might be a good opportunity for us to all get together. So, all right, guys, thanks for watching Sport Chat 503. We'll see you next time. Adios.